back straight, then I recommend that you bend your feet. Try to keep the sole of your feet on the ground if you can. Otherwise, straighten those legs out. And then we're going to have our arms by our side. Let's take a breath in. As we twist over to the right, left arm reaches past that right toe, right hand goes back behind you, and exhale as we come down. Try to bring that chest towards your knee, and then just pulse that left hand forward a few times. 3, 2, 1, let's come back up. Breathe in as we come up. Exhale, turn your joint over to the left side, and then reach forward, gazing down at your left knee now, and then pulse for 3, 2, 1, and back up. Arms out your side. Let's do this one more time. Let's breathe in as we rotate over to the left, and down, and pulse for 3, 2, 1, and up. Breathe in, and then exhale as we rotate over to the left side, reaching forward.
Your hips and hip distance apart. I want to
your butt is not up, it's not down. Pull your abs in, tuck your tailbone under, that will help to straighten your back. So as if someone could put a glass of water on your back and it doesn't fall off. So that's what we're going for. Now your elbow should be directly underneath your shoulders. Palms are on the ground. Keep your gaze on the mat in between your two, your hands. And let's rock forward and back on those toes. Too far, and that's okay. Keep going. your gaze down on the mat. Let's take a breath in. As we exhale, we're just going to gently lift up our chest just a little bit, and we'll look forward, keeping your hips evenly on the ground. And let's hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and come back down. Ready? Let's do that again. Take a breath in. To exhale, let's go ahead and lift. Gaze forward and hold for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1, and come back down. Okay, now let's take those hands a little bit further wide and our elbows are back. So it looks like from hand to head to the other hand, it's the shape of a W. Keep your gaze on the ground, and let's take a breath in. And as we exhale, we're going to lift up. And we're going to squeeze those elbows back as much as we can. So you're really squeezing the shoulder blades together, keeping your shoulders down. And then we're going to extend those arms way up, forward and then back, squeezing the elbows in and forward. Keep going. We lift our chest a little bit more every time as we squeeze the elbows back. And then lengthen the arms up front. Let's do 5 more of these. 5, 4, 3, 2, and last one, 1, and then come back down. Okay, so now we're going to swim. We have the right arm, the left arm, your arms are reaching straight out behind, your legs are reaching straight out behind, your feet are pointed. Gaze at the ground, take a breath in, and as we exhale, let's lift up our arms and our legs. And you can just hold here or start swimming. So we're fluttering our arms and our legs. We're scissor kicking and scissoring with our arms. Keep going. Keep going, you got this. Swimming away. Going for 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Let's bring those hands up underneath their shoulders. Lift that push back into a child's pose. Breaths here. And then go ahead and walk those hands forward. And let's bring our feet in front. And we're going to make our way down into our back. Okay, so one way you can do that is reach underneath your thighs and then lower yourself down, hollowing out that stomach. Come all the way down. Take our hands up overhead, and this time we're going to flex our feet, pushing our heels away from us. Palms of your hands are facing the ceiling, shoulders are down. And focus on really trying to lengthen. So push those heels far away, opposite direction of your fingers. Let's take 2 deep breaths. Let's take a breath in. And as you exhale, bring those arms up, pull your navel in, and then let's come up into a seated position using those abs to pull yourself up. This is hard. Bend your knees and grab underneath your thighs to help pull yourself up. And then we're going to extend forward at the waist and bringing those arms by our ears as we gaze between our knees. And then sit up. yourself. Pull that navel in. That'll help to lift you. And abs only. I'm going to reach up and over an imaginary ball around at our belly button. As our elbows come down towards our knees, tuck your chin in. Pull that navel in. This should feel good too. It helps open up the shoulder blades. And help stretch the lower back. Take a breath in as we come back up. And exhale again, we're gonna roll down under a grade of time. Okay, take a breath in, let's do that again. Exhale as we come up. And then roll in over that imaginary ball. extend the left leg straight out. Now we're going to bring that right knee and hug it tight in towards our chest. Let's grab the top part and the lower part of that shin with opposite hands. You can keep your head down or lift your head up. So again, we're just at the butt base of our shoulder blades, and then we're going to squeeze and go from one leg to the next, extending the opposite leg as you squeeze in the opposite knee towards your chest. Keep going. Rotate those legs over just slightly over to the right, keeping both sit bones or both of right knee, bring that right foot down, left knee bend and bring the left foot down. Let's bring our arms by our side, palms are facing down. Bring the heels in towards your glutes. Tuck your shoulder blades under, squeeze your shoulder blades together. Let's take a breath in as we step. We're going to peel off our tailbone and we're going to roll up one vertebra at a time. So make sure that your feet are about hip distance apart. You're really pushing away the earth with your feet. You don't want to push up too high. You want to have a nice straight line from your knee all the way down to your shoulder. So if you had a ball, just evenly roll down right there. Okay? We're going to reverse that. Roll down one vertebra at a time. Tailbone comes down last. Let's do that again. Tuck the tailbone, roll the tailbone up, and lift up one vertebra at a time. And this time we're going to stay up here. Let's take the right leg, bend the leg, draw that knee in towards your chest, and extend the leg out. So it's knee into chest, and extend. And we'll go three, two, and one. Let's straighten that leg, flex and point that foot. Five, four, three, two, and one. Now we're going to lower that leg as we do our hips are going to come down. And we're going to bring our hips up as the leg comes straight up. Keep going. We'll do it for three, two, and last one, one. And then bend that right leg, bring the sole of that right foot down. Keep your hips high if you can. Let's take our left knee, lift it up, squeeze that knee into towards your chest, and then lengthen the leg. Go. Keep breathing. We'll go for three, two, and one. Okay, now bring that leg straight up and flex and point your left foot. Three, two, and one. Keep your foot pointed. We're going to lower that leg down as our hips come down and then back up again. Nice good stretch in our hip flexors too as we do this. Let's do two more. Two, and last one, one. Let's bend the left leg, bring that foot back down, keep your hips lifted. Make sure your knees are just in line with your hips. And then we're going to squeeze the knees together and out. Together and out. So put the, if you can, put your hands on your hips. Make sure they're stable and they're not rocking from side to side or up and down. We want to squeeze those inner thighs together, bring the knees together. Try to keep the soles of your feet on the ground. Keep going, squeezing. Five, four, three, two, and whenever bring your knees in a little bit closer and then pulse them. So just pulsing those knees together. Your knees do not come out very wide. They don't even come out to the where your hips are. Keep going. Keep them lifted. Squeeze those glutes. And we'll keep squeezing for five, four, three, two, and one. Bring the knees back out to their line with your hips and let's roll down one vertebra at a time. Hollowing out the tummy as your hips come down and then bring your knees into your chest, hug them tight, rock them side to side. Let's tee out our arms, palms are facing down, bring your legs to the tabletop and then rotate those knees over to the right side as you as your head rotates in the opposite direction. Keep your shoulders on the ground. Down. your hip distance apart. We're going to lift up our booty, and then we're going to lower down and up. So we're working the back part of our arms. Keep your gaze just right about at the top of your knees. Squeeze your shoulder blades together as you lower. Hang in there, we're almost finished. And we're going to rotate our arms from one direction to the other. And make sure your shoulder blades are down. Strong core, don't let your belly go. Keep that belly tight. Actually, the correct term is your abs tight. Extend the right fingers down towards the ground. It's okay. cross-legged position here. Make sure your sit bones are evenly on the ground. Let's take those hands forward, shoulders are down. Rotate your palms facing away from you. Bring those palms back behind, clasping your hands, clasping your fingers together. Shoulders are down, and we're gonna lift those, put those arms up back behind us. Now if you want, you can drop your head down for deeper stretch. Just make sure that your sit bones hips stay evenly.